Hello, Canada and hockey fans of the United States and Newfoundland.
Wow, what a fucking intro. as you can see, you're on Too Many Jams. It's a show about all things 20-year-old. With help from friends, experts, and our own personal experiences, we hope to shed some light on those issues that leave our age group lost and confused. Big shout out, our beer sponsor finally came through. Farmer in the Sky, True History Brewing. It's now in 100 LCBOs. 35 in the GTA, and just the big ones. If you want to buy it, go to like a big LCBO. They should have it, and support the boys. We're going to drink it here because I'm joined with Finn. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Finn Evans, is it?
Finn Evans, yeah.
Where'd you get Finn? Like, how'd they name you Finn?
I don't know. My parents, their names are Mike and Sue, so pretty like, I guess, normal names, but my older sister's name is Willa, and then my younger brother's name's Angus, so everyone thinks we're like a pretty Irish family, but we're pretty Canadian, like all the way back, but I think they just thought
they wanted to go pretty Irish.
Yeah, mix it up a little bit, get some names. Finn's becoming more common nowadays.
Like, all I think of is Finn McCools.
Yeah, exactly. It's not spelled like that though, but yeah, everyone thinks my real name's like Finley or Phineas, but it's Finian.
Phineas.
Yeah, because Phineas and Ferb, that's a lot. That's what a lot of people think.
Is this your first pod?
Yeah, first podcast, I think.
Just keep that mic right there, locked and loaded. When you turn to me, it comes with you. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's an extension of the arm. Yeah. No, so first podcast. You know what this is? This is training. I don't know if you do any media or anything yet.
No, at school we don't do a lot of media. More when I was like, more when I was maybe younger a little bit, but not as much lately. So yeah,
it's okay, before we get into everything, I'll give a little backstory. So Finn and I actually met a few days ago. We were bartending, and I was just like asking him like what he does, and he just like low-key dropped that he's a like a D1 hockey player in the States, and obviously like just asked him a bunch of questions. I thought it was dope what he was doing. We'll get into his story here, but I just needed to give that intro so people kind of know what they're getting into. Also, yeah, let's just try the beer here real quick before we get into your story, because it's bubbling. It looks nice and crispy here.
Cheers. Pretty good beer, especially for today. Nice and refreshing.
Isn't that nice?
Really good.
Not even boosting. I told the guys, I was like, if it was bad, I'd tell you, but it's unreal.
Yeah.
So crisp.
It's a nice summer drink too. Something you could definitely drink at the cottage, something like that.
But we're going to take it a bit easy because both him and I are on the ice later. We got to skate with a lot of the pros that stay in Toronto in the summer. We all get together on, what is it, Thursdays, I think?
Thursdays.
Yeah, I know, because I'm always there. And you know, with the boys, we just rip it up. So we'll probably just sip this. But yeah, Finn's a hockey player. And if you've noticed, Robbie isn't here today. He got called into work, but we're going to make it happen anyway. And I got a bunch of questions I want to ask. So you said meaty when you were younger. Were you like lighting up like the younger days of hockey?
No. So like growing up, I mean, hockey works in like weird ways. So neither of my parents played hockey. My mom's kind of from a hockey family. She's from like Edmonton, Alberta. But my dad, he played the different sports like rugby, that sort of thing. He's like a different build than me. He's an absolute unit. Yeah, I got the lanky genes. He's more of like a power guy. But, I started off like local house league, Bill Bolton. And then one of my friend's dads, actually, my parents didn't really know much about hockey. And he was like, hey, I'll drive your kid if he plays on this select team.
Because it was a Lee Side Select. My home hood, baby.
And so I played for not even the top team, like the lower end team. And then slowly went up. And then always growing up, like I played the highest level of AAA or whatever, but I was never like, I would say I was more like middle of the pack. We had a really solid team. Like we were always like,
what team was it in triple?
Toronto Nationals, which is like a good, but like our team, we'd go to like, we would win the league a lot and that sort of thing. But I was never one of the best players. And then kind of around OHL draft year, the year before is when I kind of, for whatever reason, like,
were you filling out?
Took off. Not even like my draft year, I was like six, it's probably an inch shorter than I am now, like 6'3", like 155 pounds. So
were you not getting crushed?
Like my first year juniors, like I was 16, and there's not that many 16-year-olds. And like with my body type, yeah, I mean, when I could see the guy coming, I was fine. I was always strong on my skates, but it was when I couldn't see
You were
see
a winger, you
coming.
Said?
Yeah.
So winger. Those like those passes up the boards, those yeah. blind passes where you exactly. have to turn at the last second, you just get
yeah, I mean,
flattened.
Juniors is a different thing because when you're like, you've always played against kids your own age growing up.
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
my 16-year-old year, like the guys are 16 to 20, 21 years old sometimes. So it's definitely an adjustment. But I don't know. I've loved my year. I loved my years of junior. I guess that was a pretty long answer. But back to the question. I wasn't really like
lighting you weren't like it up. You weren't lighting the lamp. And but then closer to in junior, you kind of like turned it up a bit.
Yeah, more like the last year before junior, and then kind of took off. That's when I started looking at the OHL or going NCAA.
So like my question is, you're the first kind of. I guess athlete really that we've had on, at least somebody that's like taking it on as a career. And how different is it like high school wise? Like what's your weekends looking like? Like, are you doing all hockey? Do you have a social life?
Yeah, for sure. So that's like one thing I was really lucky the way my junior, so I went to St. Mike's the high school. And then they have a junior A team that like plays out of the
yeah, rink, majors,
but not,
yeah.
But they're like the majors is the varsity team. They have a team called like the Buzzers, which like plays out of the rink, but it's not affiliated with the school. But
their junior team's called the Buzzers.
Yeah, the St. Mike's Buzzers. And then
dope.
It was kind of really easy for me because like I never really had to drive. I just go to school, wait after practice, do my workout or whatever, and then do our practice and then bus home because I could leave my gear there. But like once like I played 2 years at St. Mike's, like my grade 11, 12 years, and then. I went, I ended up finishing in Ottawa in my last year.
And you had no life there?
And it's different. Well, actually, like, it was weird. Because most college guys, they'll take a gap year before they go into school. And I originally went out to, like, the BCHL in Vernon. So it's, like, near Kelowna. Yeah.
Nice.
Which is, like, a super nice place. But it was really weird experience for me. Because, like, as you said, like, I had kind of had a normal, even though I played junior hockey, I'd kind of had like a normal high school experience.
Like you were still able to socialize.
Exactly. Because yeah, it was kind of nice because I had my hockey friends, but then I still had all my school friends that I could like hang out with on the weekends. But then you go out there and like a lot of the, it's different. So that was like a huge adjustment for me. And I went from living like downtown Toronto to like
Vernon,
which is like, it's a beautiful place, but there's not a lot of people and you got to find other stuff to do. And honestly,
did you work out and like?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't the best fit for me there, and so then I ended up getting traded to Ottawa, and that worked out really well, and I loved it in Ottawa. But it's also a different experience when all you're doing is play hockey. Like you're not going to school, not doing anything. You kind of have to like think of stuff to fill your time.
I was gonna ask you, did you get wrapped up in a lot of this? I only know about hockey life from probably Chicklets, I'd say. And just like the few guys I know that kind of went junior in the O, but didn't quite go past that. But were you playing Fortnite? Like just.
Yeah. I mean, I'm horrible at video games. I've never been a video game guy, but like, yeah, a lot of my teammates would be playing like 5 hours.
When you're out in Vernon though, like, is that how you killed your time?
So, yeah. You guys are huge video. I mean, I've never been a video game guy. So like that was tough for me because I didn't really know it, but it's like. Yeah, some guys, everyone kind of finds their own thing, but yeah, there's definitely some huge, Fortnite was like massive in the hockey world. For
like,
sure.
Yeah, like weren't big NHLers getting addicted to it? Like we're coaches, we're like, yo,
yeah.
Like we noticed this. You could see some pro players, they posted like their account hours on how many hours they played, like, and they were like gamer level. They were like professional gamer level hours. But I was going to ask you then, because you just you talked about, first of all, I'm just gonna give myself a shout out here. It's my birthday.
There you go.
Happy and birthday. My rec hockey team's coming over later for beers.
It's a dream.
But I was just saying, I turned 27 today, and I was talking about the 27 Club, where rock stars don't make it past 27. And you listed off a bunch. Yeah. And I'm thinking, are you a music guy?
I mean, I wouldn't say I'm like a music guy. I mean, I listen to all different types of music.
Never played or anything?
I mean, I took guitar lessons like all the way growing up, but I'm like so musically like, it's just not something I was gifted with.
Just only the mitts for hockey.
Yeah. But yeah, music, I tried. I definitely tried, but I mean, I love listening to music. I just am horrible at creating it myself. I guess I can play like a couple songs on the guitar and that's about it.
Like we talking rap, we talking everything, old classic rock.
Yeah, I kind of like everything. So I'm a, like, I love rap or whatever, but I'm also like a huge country fan.
Classic.
And, yeah. And then, but I also like my old, like my two favorite bands would probably be either like Tragically Hip. Cause that's what I kind of, my uncle is like a huge guitarist and that's kind of what I grew up on, like up at the cottages. And then I like the Red Hot Chili Peppers as well, but then I don't know. My music taste is like pretty varied. So
were you still able to make it up? Sort of keep bringing it back, like high school and stuff. But I just remember playing. I didn't play AAA. I played AA, and I remember not being able to go away on weekends and stuff like that. Like, were you able to make it up to the cottages still? Like,
yeah, it's weird. So my like a lot of my friends, like it was kind of hockey all year round. Whatever. My parents weren't as much really into that. So in the summers, they always wanted me playing. I never played like spring hockey.
You didn't do like 3-on-3 in the summer?
No, so I'd do like, I'd skate towards August, but mostly I'd be playing like, I played soccer till like grade 8 or grade 9. Then I've always played tennis in the summers. And so
you kind of look like Shapovalov.
But yeah, I've always enjoyed playing other sports, but I didn't really like, I started working out like in my summers for hockey really late, I would say, like not until basically almost junior A, which is like really weird for most kids start like way younger. Like guys at my gym now, they're like, the younger groups are like really young. And I'm like, oh my God.
That's just parents like forcing their kids to like,
for sure.
You're going to be a pro athlete, honey. Go work out.
Yeah. But I used to spend pretty much my whole summers up at the cottage. Like I come down.
You kept
like
active. Like you
games.
Said, you're playing soccer and you're playing.
Yeah, for sure. Exactly. I think like my dad's a huge like believer in like playing other sports will only help you in like the sport you're playing. So I kind of believe that.
I totally agree. I think we've definitely got a lot out of your high school days and it's like, you're just saying it's pretty straightforward, like nothing crazy. Like, did you know this is what you wanted to kind of pursue in high school?
For sure. Hockey's always been like, I mean, people think of it as like this huge commitment, but it's always been kind of like normal. Like for any guy who's kind of at a higher level, it's kind of like, it's, you know, like I never thought of it as a hassle. Like it's kind of just like what I enjoy doing. And people are like, oh, you're so busy with it, but it's kind of like what you love to do. So it doesn't really feel like.
So you were like in high school, you kind of knew, you're like, you know what? I'm going to take this as far as it can go.
Yeah, 100%. Like hockey wise, like there's nothing. Obviously I want to play hockey until I can't anymore. So that's kind of always been my mentality. And it's something I love to do. So.
And your parents, are they all behind that? They're like, yeah, 100%.
For sure. Yeah, well, they wanted me to go to like a lot of my friends. When like the OHL route, they wanted me to go to college. So that was their kind of, they would have,
they said, well, do whatever you want, but like, we just need you to go to college.
Not, they would have let me go to the OHL. I think it was just,
some advice.
Yeah. Just some advice. And maybe for me, like it might like college, maybe the better option just cause I was so like skinny at the time and stuff. If I went straight to the OHL, I would have gotten destroyed.
When you're sitting there at 150 and you're telling your parents, like, I'm going to go to the show. And they're like, maybe college, my man.
Yeah, it was tough too because like all my good friends and all the guys who I'd kind of grown up playing with, they all went the OHL route. So I was like,
yeah, but they all probably had beards and like weighed 210.
Yeah, some of them, for
sure. Like 6'3", 150. I can completely imagine that weight because I was probably 6'3", 160 going into uni, and that's like stick figure.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah,
but still like. With the height, you don't really get tossed around. Like, just because you get the leverage and guys can't really, I don't know. Yeah. I never really felt abused playing hockey because intramural hockey at Western was full contact up until maybe my third year.
Okay.
So when I said I became a better hockey player later in life, I got to uni, I filled out, put on weight, and then we're playing with guys that I didn't want to pass the puck to, so I started developing hands. Yeah. I came back and like it's full contact too. And now I'm crushing guys.
Yeah, there you go.
And I came back to high school to play. There was like a fun thing where you play against the current varsity team as alumni.
Yeah.
I think I pocketed like 5 goals.
There you go.
And my coach was just like, where the fuck was I was like a mid-level winger on the team, like maybe third line. He's like, dude, he's like, you had that the whole time. Yeah. I was like, buddy, you never developed me properly.
Yeah,
right?
The thing about hockey too, you never know when it's gonna come to you. So It's kind of one of those things where you grind it out as long as you can, see what happens.
No, but it's cool because it, like, we can get to what it kind of afforded you, but basically coming out of school, you played in Vernon, then you played in Ottawa, and then you ended up getting accepted to Princeton.
Yeah, so for me, I mean, back to it, like, I was pretty lucky in having that, like, kind of, I got on, like, radars kind of early when in my, like, draft year for the OHL, and then from there it was easier because I committed to school, like, going into grade 11.
Oh, so you're already committed.
Yeah, I was committed in, like, grade 11, I think. I can't, but
Then why all the years in between, they just said take some time, yeah, like, get so bigger?
I was the youngest player on the team this year at school, even though I'd taken that year just because I have a later birthday. But most guys will take, for hockey, they'll take 1, 2, or 3 years off. So, like, we had 2 or 3 freshmen this year who'd taken 3 years off. And then, yeah, so it doesn't really matter. Once you get to the college level, it's all a wash anyways. So,
okay. I wanted to ask a bunch of questions about how college hockey works, yeah. But, like, first question is, Princeton, obviously dope school.
Yeah.
For sure. You get in grade 11. How hard are you flexing that, like, in grade 12?
No, some of my friends, like, one of my good friends had also, like, committed to Harvard at the time. So it was kind of, like, not as big. I don't know. It was definitely nice having it in high school, though, just because, you know, you didn't have that, like, stress of trying to get into. I mean, obviously, I had to maintain good grades, but it was never really, like, I never had that beginning of grade 12, like, grind sort of thing, which was super nice. But, I mean,
but, like, you didn't mind when people asked you at parties, like, where you're going, and you're like, oh, you know, not a big deal. Like, yeah, I just got accepted at Princeton last year. And, you know what I mean? Just mix that in.
Sometimes I find it, like, awkward saying, like, because it's, everyone thinks, like, it's kind of got this, like, big name. You know, there's a lot of schools in the States that are, like, really, really good, and not a lot of people know about them. Princeton has that, like, name to it. So
you kind of feel douchey saying it. Yeah.
You kind of feel arrogant saying it. So I usually just, like, I just say I just go to school in the States.
I think the best way to play that, like, when you're doing something cool, the best way to play it is low key and then hope that one of your friends says it. So you can be like, nah.
Yeah, like, I don't really care.
You'd be like, yeah, no, you say, like, I'm playing college hockey in the States.
Yeah.
And then leave it at that and, like, wait for them to be like, but where?
Yeah. Exactly.
Or a friend to be like, at Princeton, bitch. Yeah. Heard of it? No, I think that's super cool. I said it right when you were telling me this. I'm fucking jealous.
Yeah.
I wouldn't trade my college history. I had a great time. Just kidding. I would fucking trade it to play college hockey at Princeton. Yeah. What I want to ask you. Okay, so how does this work? You said Princeton is D1. You said it's one of the top colleges in the States. Is D1 universal across the States? Is there a separation between Ivy League schools, or is there, like, divisions based on geography? Like, how does it work?
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, that's like a. So there's, like, I can't remember, maybe 5 or 6 divisions in college hockey, and so the Ivy League schools are part of it. Like, it's not called the Ivy League. Like, some of the sports at our school, they just play within the Ivy League division. But for hockey, whatever reason, it's called the ECAC.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it's geographical. So you play against, like, mostly, it's mostly, like, upstate New York schools. It's, like, smaller schools, but honestly, like, really good hockey program schools. So, like, the winner, the team who won the ECAC last year was, like, Clarkson, which, like, not a lot of people have heard about it, but it's, like, a really, really good hockey school. They pump up pros, and then, yeah, so you play against, like, the Ivy Leagues, but there's also, like, I think 6 other teams.
So would you, like, because all I've heard about from college hockey from Chicklets is that all their guys go to Boston College, and, yeah, like, how does that compare? Like, what division are they in?
Same Division One. Like, well, if we play out-of-conference games, like, this year, like, our out-of-conference games were, like, trying to think, we played Penn State twice, we played like Arizona State twice, we played, like, those types of schools. It's the same thing, honestly.
How do you stack up against some, like, Princeton? You said,
yeah, it's weird. Like, the ECAC is, like, usually a little bit older league, like, a lot of but honestly, a lot of the time ECAC teams win just because it's a more defensive structure. So it's just weird. Like,
because they're older guys, they're probably playing more disciplined, and you got younger guys in the other college teams trying to score and stuff.
For sure.
It's like when the current varsity team at a high school plays the alumni. Yeah. The alumni usually win.
Yeah.
Just because they're solid.
Yeah. It's exactly. It's they're honestly men. They're different styles of game.
Yeah.
obviously all the schools are like Division One. Like I'd say 80% of them. The biggest thing with college hockey is like probably 70% of teams could beat any other team on a given night.
Yeah,
so
I got you.
It's kind of like that.
So you do. But, you are comparable. Like it's good hockey. Like it stacks up.
Yeah, exactly. Like our. Yeah, yeah. It's pretty much the same.
And what I don't know if that was that entire question, but. So when you're at Princeton, or when you're at college, I don't have to keep, you know, dropping the big P. Is hockey big there? Like, you have fans at your games?
Yeah. So ours is, I mean, it's weird at school because our rink itself is like my first ever college game was at Penn State, and that's like obviously a huge like sports school, and they have like
boost full crowd.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like 8,000. Probably over 8,000 people, and it's like all students, and they've got like a sign for every guy on your team. They're throwing stuff. It's that type of like college atmosphere, dude, which you think of, which is like
that's
awesome.
What I want.
Yeah, there you go. But then Princeton's a little different, first of all, because the school is so small. Like we only have like 5,500 undergrads, so and then our rink's kind of small. We used to like sell out most of our games, but we only fit like just under 3,000 or something like that. And like I wouldn't say there's the best. Like you're really good friends with all the athletes, but there's like from all the students, probably not the best like athlete. Like nobody's going before the games and tailgating sort of thing. Because it's kind of a different atmosphere.
They're but a bunch of nerds. I get it.
Where we get our fans mostly is like townspeople from Princeton who like bring their kids family. Yeah. So it's definitely. I mean, it's still an atmosphere for sure, but it's like different when you go to like these. Other schools, but
like you're not like at these other schools, like you're like kind of like a superstar. Like people would know who you are, especially if you play football or basketball. Yeah. I don't know how hockey is at these other states. So at Princeton, like would people know the players on the team?
Yeah.
Or
yeah, I mean everyone. I mean, well, student wise, everyone kind of knows everyone because it's small.
So like you even like when you're talking about students, like you recognize a lot of the students just because it's that tight knit of a college.
Sure, for sure, especially the American culture is a little different. It's like. I don't know if it's like exaggerated at Princeton because it's like there's more of a difference between the athletes and non-athletes. But like growing up in Canada, like not a lot of my female friends for whatever reason like played sports. It wasn't, I don't think as many, like obviously there are some, but but in the U.S. like all of my friends at school, they're female athletes. So it's like a kind of different culture in that sense, which is kind of like I found that interesting.
Interesting, eh?
Yeah, well, it's just like.
Do you got a girl down there or here?
No.
Okay, still rocking a single life.
Yeah.
So like, do you find yourself like are the female athletes there? Like, are you like, do you guys hook up with them, or is it more like friendship?
I think probably a little bit of both. It's basically like the same as any. It's just like a lot of the time you're hanging out with other athletes for whatever reason.
Yeah. So it's like it's just like a friend group. Like even
it's,
at school,
it's
like
not
obviously
even a friend group. It's just like yeah. I mean, it's not like. The people who aren't athletes aren't hanging out with us too. It's like
that's like okay. That's why it's kind of yeah,
yeah. Because you kind of yeah.
I didn't know if like you guys were like kind of a tight crew, and then you'd like go out and party and like.
Well, I mean, if you think like at a school, at my school, the school is so small, but every sport we have is Division One.
That's
so
insanity.
So they have to have like 1/3 of our school is athletes. So that's like.
And the other half is nerds.
Yeah, sorry. Did I say 1/2 or 1/3? I meant 1/3. But okay.
Maybe you said
no. They're not. There's a lot of really smart kids, but yeah.
Maybe no. There's probably some like absolute all arounders there, like smart, like still ready to fire it up, party style, college style. What I found like super interesting about Princeton that you explained to me is that there's not fraternities, or at least not like legitimate ones. But you have this thing called meal clubs.
Yeah, they're called eating clubs.
Eating clubs. Okay, and. I don't know if I when I edit this up, if I can, I'll try to like Google it and throw in some pictures right here when you're describing it. But basically, let me see if I have this right. They're big mansions similar to what a fraternity would have. They have an executive board or a board that runs it similar to what a fraternity has, except it's co-ed.
Yeah.
No one really lives at the house except for maybe the top executives. Exactly. But they're massive estates for just kind of like eating, entertaining, and hanging out.
They're more like, I think people call them like they're like
social clubs.
Exactly. So it's like, I mean, it's been around for like Princeton a long time ago, like band, fraternities and sororities.
They're like, we need a dope or more Ivy League version of this.
Well, I think, I mean, I haven't experienced it firsthand, but the whole fraternity, like, I think we were talking about the other day, the whole fraternity sorority thing in the States is like crazy, like
it's
what these kids have to go through, which like, so I can understand why they'd ban it. But yeah, they have eating clubs, and like there's a street called Prospect Avenue, which is like right, it's basically on campus. And but the eating clubs actually aren't associated with the school. Like the school doesn't.
Yeah,
run
okay, I got you.
But the school they allow it. They allow it. But yes, I think six of the eating clubs are, like you have to not pledge, but you have to kind of get in. You have you do.
Yeah, you have to meet the people. Processes. You gotta, yeah. Which is you a little bit in. Similar to yeah, fraternities.
Yeah, but I think it's less like it's not like you're. Just
yeah, it's
like,
not like hey, chug this beer, tea. Pussy.
Yeah, exactly. It's more just like you're having conversations with people, and then the other six anyone can get into, and you just yeah, you just. Get in or whatever, and then you eat your meals there. Your junior.
How many meals like a week, like, or is it like you go there for your meals every week? Like that's no, where you eat. Like that's your dining hall.
Exactly. And the meals are really good. Like really, really good. So it's because you kind of have to compete with the other. Like you want people to join your.
You're competing on meals.
Exactly. So the food ends up being like really good, but yeah, and then they hold all the night events, and it's like it's actually a really good time.
And you show me some pictures, like big artists kind of sometimes have concerts there.
Yeah, so they do these things called, oh, what are they called? Oh, I'm completely blanking on them. hopefully I'll remember them. But they do basically do, oh, lawn parties. They're called lawn parties.
Dope.
And they do them dope. one kind of around 2 weeks into school, 1 or 2 weeks into school. And then they'll do one like kind of near the end. And like I was there. Cause I didn't like, obviously I knew like everyone had fun at school, but I didn't think of Princeton as like a huge like party school. And it was like one of the craziest things I've experienced. Like that first lawn parties was like beautiful. The all Prospect Avenue is like packed. And they had like Waka Flocka, which was super random, but kind of hilarious. And then they had Two Friends, which like, I don't, do you know the Big Booty remixes? You know, okay, they're like, if you go into any hockey dressing room, I'm sure you'll hear them. They're like these SoundCloud
remixes. Yeah, I haven't gotten the invite to a hockey dressing room recently.
They're like big DJs, and they were there. And then also Cheat Codes, which is like a huge DJ. They all performed, and I was like, oh my God. And then they had end of the year, and it was like Boogie with a Hoodie, which is a big artist as well. So it was like, it's these crazy events, which I think the school puts on. They have like a $60,000 budget for each one to like get musicians. And then they just, it's a lot of fun.
Dude, that's unreal. And it's like fraternities have that too. It's cool. It's cool that they still have their own version. It'd be one thing if they kind of outright banned fraternities and was like, don't do anything else. Yeah. But that's dope.
The way I look at it, it's kind of like, I don't know. It's kind of like having that frat social scene without all the kind of extra, like not unnecessary of hazing stuff.
I was going to ask you, as we were talking about it, luckily the fraternity I was at Western.
I think Canadian is completely different ballgame.
It was so chill.
Yeah.
They didn't make you like chug piss or whatever they do in the States. And we still got to have that like college party experience. Yeah. Like a few DJs come through and stuff like that. But what I was going to ask you, cause we were both talking, we were like, oh man, we would never do that stuff. But I wanted to ask you, I hear in Chicklets a lot, like obviously every team has rookie parties. Yeah. The hockey party we're having tonight is a rookie party for our men's league.
There you go.
I was wondering if like, did you have rookie parties for Princeton? Did you have rookie parties for your junior teams and all that?
Juniors is a little different. It depends on the team, juniors. But right around the time for my like rookie party juniors, there was a huge, in the same league, there was this huge scandal about like, it was something bad, it was just
classic.
Not good. So ours was pretty low key, which is, I guess, good for me. But then at school, we do have like they have our, like the, I guess, hazing, but it's not even, ours is, at school, I thought it was like, I can't really say much about it because it's kind of like a school tradition or whatever.
Oh, got you.
So I can't really like go into that because like every freshman doesn't really know about it. And then you kind of,
it's a secret.
It's definitely, I mean, it's like, it's fun. I would say a word to describe is just funny. Like it's nothing. You're not like, I've heard some from other schools and it's like, I've heard like this one school, like they blindfolded the guys and like put them in a cabin in the middle of the woods and they woke up and there was just like snakes everywhere. Like there wasn't like that, like nothing like that. It was like, I mean, you're definitely sweating a little bit, but I thought it was
pretty
funny.
A pretty good tone. I remember for our fraternity, one of our parties with the sorority, we just did a rookie party themed party. We all wore jerseys and like, I think we all chugged Goldfish and stuff like that.
Yeah. I mean, you're always a part of like, I don't know. For me, it's like some stuff's funny, but like once you get into like that, like that's fine, like go up. But like once
is
you
it
get
fine
in,
though?
I don't know.
Like how do they? How do those fish die, man?
I guess. But like growing up, when you're no longer the rookie, and you kind of have to do it to the I mean, for me, I'm like, I don't want to see this kid. Like it gets funny if they're like, it's kind of a joke, whatever. Seeing them kind of struggle a bit, but you don't want to like be like legitimately hurting kids. So
same as you. So I get it. You can't really talk about it. Yeah. And like junior, did you do anything like? Did they just booze you up?
Yeah,
like,
it was more. Yeah, it was more based on stuff like that. It wasn't. I mean, there's a couple. Like, I think there's one in one of my teams. Like, hilarious things where, like, obviously all the rookies would have to like dress up in like embarrassing clothes, that sort of thing. You play like these like drinking games or whatever, where you kind of screw them a little bit. But it's nothing like too bad. But it like a lot of the one thing you do have to watch over is like a lot of the kids haven't really. Some kids,
if they're from the States, they haven't really drank.
So
yeah,
it's like.
You came in there just hot. You're like, I've been drinking since I was 14. Like, I made that up, but like, probably.
Yeah, I mean, it's a different culture for sure. Especially, that was a big thing, like, not even hockey-wise, at school. Since the drinking age is 20, there's a way stricter drinking culture in the U.S.
That's why people literally die when they turn 21.
So it, not even when they turn 21, like, when you get to school and you're like, I mean, you're going to have booze available to you. It's that's the way it goes. But these kids have never drank before, and then they're not around, like, friends that they really know, they're trying to impress people, and they end up just getting like a bunch of kids.
Like if they're next to you, you're both 20, and you're handling five beers no problem because you've been drinking heavy beer for years now. They're gonna die.
Yeah. So at school, they had a lot of problems with kids who had never drank before, and then they end up getting like sent to the. I don't think anything really bad happens, but they get just sent to the hospital, that sort of thing.
Just, yeah, we've all been there. But do you think, speaking of not being able to talk about stuff? Do you think Princeton has like secret societies?
I don't know. I've heard, like, I haven't really talked with anyone about that, but I've heard like all these different, like, not Illuminati, but that sort of thing. Like,
I think is it Harvard was like Skull and Bones, or that might be all the Ivy ones.
Yeah, I have no clue. I honestly don't know much about it.
You've heard nothing of it.
Not
just
really.
A couple
like, I mean,
rumors.
I think if they're recruiting people, it wouldn't be. Me, that's for sure. I think there's other
guys.
Hey,
you're missing out. Finn's a good guy. Yeah, all right, secret societies, bring him in.
But I know they have a lot of, like, they obviously have a lot of huge alumni at the school, and I've heard, like, there's something, but I've never, like, personally, like,
you've just heard there's something.
Yeah, yeah.
Just, like, ghosts or something.
Even more, like, before when I got in school, people brought that up, but I didn't really notice anything at school.
They're like, yeah, you get recruited to the whole. That's unreal. But, okay, maybe not rookie parties, but you're always on the road, probably, right? Like, always on buses and stuff like that. Or on all these teams, like, was there some good, like, pranks?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, like, you have, like, all your classic, like, hockey, like...
What are the classics that you see?
Like, the classics are, like, you'll go out to dinner. I mean, you have, like, your rookie dinners where the rookies pay for everything, but then you also have, like, shoe checks, like, that sort of thing where you just basically, like, one random kid, you'll, like, you won't really notice, but a kid will probably go onto the table, take whatever, like, a thing of butter, smear it on someone's shoe, and then you'll get like a ding of the glass and everyone will have to check their shoes. And it's, I mean, that's just like kind of hockey stuff. But then, I mean, honestly, in junior, since I played in the Toronto area, we didn't go as many road trips. So I didn't really, until BC was like insane when I was out there. It was like, you're driving like 8-10 hours for one game, that sort of thing. And then in college, I mean, the road's like the, honestly, one of the more fun things. Like
in the States. Yeah. You're just going college to college.
Yeah. Yeah. One thing for our team is, like, we usually drove back on the Saturday after
games. Oh, so you wouldn't stay in the town?
No, you wouldn't stay in the town. Like, teams, when they come visit us, they'd come out with us after sometimes, especially if they're
really?
Flying.
Even after a game, they'll just come out with you guys?
Yeah, so it's kind of like a known, like, you're not going to, like, be nice to them on the ice. Like, that's kind of, I think, the best thing about hockey is, like, a lot of the times the guys you hate the most on the other team, honestly,
they're just going hard.
Turn out
yeah,
to
exactly.
be like more your type of guy off the ice. So, I mean, you're not like, but like, yeah, after we'll be like, hey, if you guys want to come, like, no worries. Like, Arizona State came out with us this year and stuff. So, I don't know. It's kind of like a respect thing. Like, you're going to try to kill each other on the ice, but once you're done.
So there's no like, do you have any like rivals where you just like hate their fucking guts?
I mean, when you're playing them. Also, I've only been at college 1 year, so it's not as, I haven't had as much of that. I mean, in juniors, my last year in Ottawa, there's two top teams in that league, which is like the team I was on, the Ottawa team. And then there's a team called Carleton Place, and Carleton Place had won like the 4 or 5 years previous, like straight, and they had like a huge rivalry, and that was a lot of fun. But it's tough also in college to get that huge rivalry, because first of all, you play less games, so you only play the teams twice a year. And then playoffs, it's not like junior hockey or pro hockey where you're playing a 7-game series. Mm-hmm. It's just you play 2 games. If you win both, you move on to the next round. And then if it's 1-1, then you play a 3rd game on the Sunday. Yeah. So it's tough to build those like rivalries because like in the 7-game series, like you're going against them like every night, like back to back, and it's just like you build up this intense. I mean, playoff hockey for me is still like the most fun thing I'll ever do. So college, I mean, that's the one maybe thing that's kind of tough about college is you can't really. But it's honestly the way the college game works is it's so heavy that like if you did have those 7-game series, like
you'd die.
Yeah, guys would be
like these are men you're playing against, absolute
yeah,
men
for sure. Yeah, like court, like yeah, some teams are just like Cornell is known to be like a really heavy team, and when you come out of the like games,
Cornell
like,
they're just it. Known to be units, eh?
Yeah, for whatever reason, they just that's the way they recruit, and they're like their fans are actually crazy. They get like a crazy atmosphere. I guess it's like been a tradition for a while, so their rink's like, I know it's not small, but it's not like huge, but they pack it, and they're loud. It's really loud in there. It's actually
and you're
like,
getting
really
like booed
fun.
And shit, and like
oh for sure, they have all these traditions. Like when you're starting there, they'll like put up newspapers when they're announcing your name.
How distracting is that?
I mean, when you're playing, you're not really thinking about it. It kind of gets you more into the game.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, I'd sure. be fired up. Like,
yeah, for sure.
I don't know. I wouldn't know. Again,
yeah.
Beer league. There's like one guy's girlfriend in the audience, and I'm literally playing
yeah,
just
there
to.
You go.
That's the crowd right there. I'm like, gonna show off. Oh fuck! I had another question I wanted to ask about all that. Oh yeah. So you haven't built up the rivalries yet. You're a young guy, so yeah. They kind of you got to stay. You got to know your role. You're kind of
for
playing.
Sure.
On the lower lines in the mix, and you'll work your way up as
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I mean that's hopefully the plan. Like last year was like, I mean for me probably like the most frustrating year hockey. Like I loved every second of it,
but it's
like,
just you're used to being a
yeah,
kind of
exactly.
higher. Yeah,
and I mean part of that's on me. Like I just didn't really like produce last year, and that's.
But you said it's a lower scoring league.
Yeah,
and you're on a lower line that's not getting put on a power play
yeah, exactly.
penalty kill. Like. When are you going to get your goals? But
yeah.
Is there still good chirps out there?
Like kind of for me is different. Cause like when I was in juniors or whatever, when I was maybe older or whatever, playing a little
so
more.
So you
like,
felt
you
like
have,
you felt a little bit more loose.
I mean,
the chirps
if I'm
out.
In college, like, I mean, I haven't really proven myself at that level yet. So if I say something to stuff, like I'll get into it with someone, but it's like, can't really say much. Cause they'll like, if it's like the top scoring guy on the other team, like what are you gonna say to him, right? He's gonna be like
what have you heard some good ones? Like what are some like inter-school chirps that you've heard or just like some good
like on the ice?
Yeah
on the ice it's not really like people aren't really like chirping about your school. I mean some schools you'll play them which are like maybe not as well heard and you'll just be like all right like I don't even like no one would ever go to your school but but it was no it's
but
more
even,
like
some
from
good
the
chirps.
Fans it's just from the fans like I remember it like I can't remember I think it was maybe Penn State or Cornell, and there's a guy on our team, and his last name's like Krishka or something. And like one of the signs in the stands was like, which I thought was kind of funny. Like the guys were telling me about this. It was like they spelled out his name, and they're like, well, you couldn't find a vowel because his name's all just like
just sounds.
Yeah, exactly. So like I don't know. I thought that's most of like the school, like in between school rivalry is like. I mean, chirps are like from the fans to you.
Yeah, I got you.
So
you guys just be like on ice. You might be like, you suck, or like,
yeah,
you're
like
shit.
I don't even like honestly don't pay much attention to them, but they'll have like all these signs that are basically like
just chirping other
the
players.
School or like I can't even like yeah.
Is the slang all the same? Like hockey slang got made popular. Like there was a period of time where it was like jokes
yeah.
to make those like hockey like mom sauce me the fucking peas
yeah,
you beauty
that,
or something
yeah, that
like that
meme.
and then there was a period of time where girls I don't know why but I remember at university and like girls thought it was cool to talk hockey like
yeah.
a hockey slang. Do you remember
yeah.
that period at all?
Yeah, I mean
maybe
yeah.
it was high school. I can't remember. So like are the slangs all this like there's no new slang right?
No,
like it's still all like
I mean I think guys like if you're talking like that all the time, you're probably, I mean, I probably say stuff and people are like, oh, what do you even,
like, do you call goals tucks?
Yeah, we'll call, yeah, that's, yeah, we'll call other stuff tucks too, but it's
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Yeah. yeah, so it's like, I mean, I guess I do, like, we do talk, like, I mean, it's funny, because like my team, even though we're in the US, like 20 out of all of 27 of us are Canadian, so it's like,
that's wild.
We all grew up kind of like in the same atmosphere, so we all kind of, I guess talk the same, but I don't know. You try to tone it down when you're not like at the rink because you don't want to
yeah,
seem like
you
just
said
an
zero. I probably said more hockey slang than you, but I just find it hilarious.
Yeah,
and you're
I mean, you know what, like, for me, it's like you kind of gotten to be in the right, like, situation to be saying that stuff, but I don't know, it's like,
it's the same stuff is what you're saying.
Yeah, yeah. I don't even notice if I'm saying, sometimes I don't even notice if I'm, like, talking. I mean, people make fun of me for, like, stuff I say, but the biggest thing is, like, people at school always make fun of my, like, my Canadian accent. Like,
they think, you think so?
Yeah, for sure. They, I mean, and then when I came back here, people are like, oh, you kind of got, like, an American. And I'm like, I don't think my voice is, but they, when I ever say, like, something with an O in it, and even.
So they can hear it. So, like, the aboot thing is real.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, like, I don't hear it at all.
I, like, my O's, like, I'll, like, lengthen my O's, I guess. That's what they always say.
Yeah, okay.
So I don't really know. But then, like, some people even hear, like, they think I talk, like, too, like, Canadian, too. So I don't know. I think it's just maybe even just a hockey thing.
Not you know what? I don't know. You don't talk like a hockey player.
No, yeah.
You don't talk like a deep North Canadian.
Yeah.
You seem to balance that line pretty well. Like, when you first told me what you did, let me see. I assumed, like, just from the way you talk and appearances, I assumed that you were just, like, just getting into, like, a Queens program or, like, you know what I mean?
Well, the funny thing is, like, most of my friends in high school who go to, like, Queens, Western, McGill, all those schools, like, most of them, like, well, St. Mike's is different because it's, like, a big hockey school, but, like, all my friends pretty much played hockey. So, like, that's kind of the way we talk, like, in between our friend group. And it's not like when they go to school, that changes. So, it's just, like, I don't know. They still talk the same. So, it's kind of fun. Yeah.
Dude, I just need some new hockey slang, man. It's my favorite. It's my favorite way to talk.
Yeah.
And then my other questions are, why don't you grow the flow out?
Oh, well, I mean, I have. Before this summer, it was pretty long. I cut it, like, when I got back. But honestly, I kind of just, like, hair-wise, I'll just let it grow and then I'll just buzz it off. Sort of thing. I mean, last year, I can show, I had a pretty brutal... Oh, sorry.
When you turn away from the mic, it's going to be no sound for like that. But you're saying last year...
I had, like, in... for our playoffs in Ottawa, we knew we were, like, probably going to go on a deep playoff run.
You get a mohawk.
So we were like... really solid team. We were, like, top five in the country all year. So, like, we kind of expected. I mean, in previous years, people had, like, it's a hockey thing to, like, bleach your hair in the playoffs. Junior hockey thing.
Is that bleach or is that normal?
No, this is normal.
Okay.
People think I'd, but it's not.
Because, like, it's, like, brown underneath and then, like, sun dyed on the top.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's from, like, I don't know. It's weird because this has been, like, kind of reoccurring. I had this when I was younger and then it went away and now it's starting to come back. So everyone thinks I've been, like, frosting my tips or whatever. But no, like, previous years they'd be like, oh, we should dye our hair, but, like, our teams weren't as solid, so you could, like, be out in the first round in 2 weeks and you'd have got this, like, dyed hair. Whereas last year, like, kind of knew we were going on a deep run, and so me and a couple of the boys on the team, we shaved each other's heads.
Nice.
Not shave, like, shaved the sides. So I had long hair and then they just shaved the sides and then they just, like, shaved the lines in the side. And then we,
for,
like,
speed, for aerodynamics.
And then we, like, self-bleached our hair and it ended up being pretty, like, I mean, I thought it was funny, but, like,
probably looked like shit
at the time. Yeah, she was, like, she's not too happy about it. But, yeah, neither was my mom. She hated it. But it was pretty funny. And guys in our team were, like, one guy had, like, his mohawk, like, braided. It was the whole deal.
Dude, I'm into that. You know what? From hearing all your stories about being a hockey player, I've started to think that I also was a college hockey player. I also got a mohawk in first year.
Yeah, exactly.
I've had a lot of these experiences. I'm just going to invent that I was also on the varsity team at Western.
There you go.
But, like, what's the lifestyle like now? So you're settled in college. You're going to go into your sophomore year.
Yeah.
In the summer times, like, kind of take me through like the lifestyle of an athlete now at your level.
Yeah. So it's kind of weird because, like, in college, we're not paid, right? So when you get to the summers, you're like...
Not paid, right. Do you have a car over the side? No, I'm just kidding. There's no presents for you. But, is there a new watch?
I mean, we get a lot of stuff from the school. Like a lot... No, not really getting watches, but, like, we get treated pretty well in terms of, like, our like, all the stuff.
Merch.
Yeah, exactly. Which is, like, fully legal stuff. It's just, like, nice to have. But then, when you come home, like, you still, like, your parents will only be paying everything for you. So it's... But, like, everyone is on, like, if you kind of want to go to the next level hockey, you have to be on a pretty high-intensity, like, training plan.
Yeah.
So that's why it's, like, it's tough to get jobs because you're working out usually in the morning, skating in the mornings, and then no job is really, like, so that's why I did that.
That's also why I work at SIPR, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Same deal. Same exact program.
That bartending thing. So it's like you kind of got to, it's kind of tricky because you want to like, you don't want to be like living off your parents really because it's kind of unfair. But at the same time, like you got to figure out stuff where you can earn money, but also like follow that. Because if you're not doing that training like program, you're probably going to fall pretty hard far behind.
So it's just basically every day or do you get some days off?
Monday to Friday.
And what does your days consist of like workout wise?
Yeah. So it changes. I work out like the BioSteel gym up near St. Mike's and
what did you call it?
It's called the BioSteel. Yeah, like the sports drink.
Yeah. Okay, sorry, you said it so quick. You said it sounded like Basta.
No, BioSteel, sorry.
And, Basta sounds dope, though.
But, yeah, and then usually you'll have, like, we'll usually do workouts every day pretty much, but, like, the trainer there, he likes to switch it up. So on, like, Fridays, it's usually, like, an out-of-sight workout. So we'll go to, like, a beach volleyball place, do a beach workout, and then, like, play volleyball at the end, that type of stuff. We'll go to a gymnastics place. We'll do MMA. It's like, so it's kind of like.
They're teaching how to fight and stuff?
Yeah. I mean, it's not even as much like to learn how just to fight. It's just like, it's a good, like it's good physical exercise and it's like something new to teach your
body. And you said a lot of like Toronto NHL guys come back here to work at this gym and stuff like that.
Yeah. Like Matt, the guy who runs it, is like really well respected. And so a lot of the there's like a huge NHL group there, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, man, you're saying that you guys have some open or not open skates, but you guys play some scrimmages like once a week.
Yeah.
And can anyone come down and watch them or is it
like anyone can come? Like, I mean, it's just at St. Mike's, anyone can kind of walk in, but it's like, I mean, I'll go out like some of the time. It's mostly if they, I'll go out like decent amount of the time, but like, yeah, all those guys, it's kind of a scrimmage and, one of the trainers is the coach of his team and it gets kind of competitive, but
is there anyone playing in those that's not like in the show, going to the show or like playing some, is there like, do any of the people playing in that are just buddies with the guys?
No. So everyone playing it works out at the gym.
Okay.
So, and then it's basically NHL guys. There's AHL guys. There's like a couple guys who play in Europe. And then there's like a couple
college hockey. Yeah. No, that's cool.
But as a college guy, we kind of just like, we'll go. If they have too many numbers, we won't go. But yeah.
So. But like, so you're going on vacation next week. When you go on vacation, will you do any exercising?
Yeah. So like that, I don't know. This one's like, I'm going on vacation because like it's with my grandparents and like we usually, I haven't seen them while we tried to do a trip. Like I'm super excited for the trip, but yeah, it's definitely like tough because you've like worked out the whole
summer. Yeah, you don't want to lose it.
Exactly. So yeah, I mean, we're on a boat like a lot of the times, so it'll be tough to, but like,
Just fucking get them to tow you behind the boat and just swim.
I'm a horrible swimmer, so I love that would work. But you're basically like, you can do like basically body weight workouts and, you know, I'll ask my trainer just to send me like some stuff to do. But I mean, the whole gym takes like 5 days off next week. Just as I kind of
perfect
rest
timing,
week.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Are you the final set of questions here? You having fun?
Yeah.
You like podcasts?
Yeah, there you go. It's been, I don't even know how long it's been.
You'll get a chicklet. It's been about 48 minutes.
Really?
But this is just prepping for the chicklets. So are you a hockey fan? Are you a Leafs fan?
Yeah, I'm a Leafs fan. I mean, my whole family's like hugely. It kind of sucks sometimes because the tickets are so expensive to go to the games.
Yeah, you're not telling me they got any hookups for a couple up and coming hockey players. Do you know any guys on the team like with from the gym?
On the Leafs, no, there's no Leafs guys at the gym. I mean, one of my good friends growing up, his dad played for the Leafs for a long time, so he, like I would go with him to a lot of games.
And I'm sure that guy's got no shortage of fucking Leafs access.
That was super nice because you could go to the games and you didn't have to spend a lot of money. But it's pretty cool like seeing your friends, like a lot of the kids I grew up playing with, a lot of like my good friends playing in the NHL.
You got buddies in the NHL already?
Yeah, one guy who we kind of got drafted the same spot, he ended up just winning the cup with
he's
St.
on the Blues?
Louis, yeah. And
fuck yeah.
Yeah, he's a really young kid. Like I wouldn't say we're like, I don't know, we're kind of...
What
like,
are you, are you 20 now?
Yeah, I'm 20.
So. Yeah, so he won a cup at 20?
I'm turning 20. Yeah, I think he's 20 now. But yeah, he was by far the youngest guy on that team. But then, yeah, some of the, just seeing guys, like we had three guys from our team this year at school sign and play the rest of the year in the NHL. So it's just cool seeing your friends kind of take off.
So when you go the college route, are you hoping, like, did those guys that got signed, did they finish their college career or did they go to the hockey and then do some sort of summer stuff?
A lot of guys, college-wise, will sign in their, like, junior years.
Will they finish?
After their junior year, they'll go play and then they'll do summer stuff.
Summer stuff, got you.
At school, like, at Princeton, it's pretty hard to do that. So these guys probably could have signed after their.
But they waited till the
end. But they just, you know, 3 years at school is like really tough academically. So they're like, we've done this, we might as well finish it off.
And it and they get to go to the NHL.
There you go. Yeah. And they, yeah, they make a lot of money now. So
what is your player like style? Like who's your favorite player? Who you playing like?
I don't know. I mean, I always like used to get asked that question when you're in like the draft process and all that. And
I'm drafting. I'm actually an agent or the scout.
I always used to say like, I don't know, like someone like Jeff Carter, someone who's like goal scorer, big body, smart hockey player. But honestly, like
it's not tough. A big
it's
deal.
It's tough to like compare yourself because it's like, oh, like whatever. But I'd say like.
But like that's what you're like modeling after. Yeah.
Yeah. More. But for me, it's just like I. Big winger likes to use my size, like that sort of thing.
Not afraid to get in the corners, bang the bodies, corner. Pucks in deep.
Yeah.
No, man, I'm it's unreal. I'm super jealous. That's why I go so hard at beer league. It's because I'm still holding on to the dream. Yeah. Hopefully, my kid, I'm gonna force him to become a pro hockey player so I can live my dreams for him. Like every good parent,
live vicariously through your kid.
Yeah, exactly. But other than that was everything on my list. Thanks so much for coming on.
No worries, my pleasure.
That was unreal. Yeah. And also big shout out to True History for the beers. Solid. Not even boosting their tires for a simple cold pilsner. Like it's probably the best I've had. And that's coming from a palateless guy. So that's huge. And Finn, do you have like an Insta? Like how do people follow you?
Yeah, I mean, I have Instagram.
It's do you have a Finsta?
No, I don't have a Finsta. Yeah, I think my Instagram's just like Finn. Honestly, I don't know. I think it's Finn Evans. I think I used to have my hockey number. I can honestly check.
It's probably Finn Evans in your birth year, knowing you.
Finn Evans, like 13.
What is your hockey number?
My hockey number is 16.
Okay, cool.
Sweet. But, mine's Finn Evans 13. It's my old hockey.
Finn Evans 13. Hopefully a strong college.
Yeah, hopefully.
Strong college, probably, man. Keep working out. Keep getting big. Make it to the show.
There you go.
And we'll do another podcast when that happens. But thanks for coming on, dude.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
And we'll see you next Tuesday. Yeah.